Come on.
I just wanna be in this moment, right in this moment. Not in the morning, I want it every day. I wanna move forward.
Hey yo, good morning YouTube, what's poppin'?
And Dunedin's absolutely beautiful. We've been here for about 5 years now. We had 1 year away, but we just wanted to take you guys through some amazing things that you must see and do when you're here.
Okay, so all of these places are in no particular order, guys. The easiest, most accessible, free things that you can do in Dunedin. There's a lot of other things that you can do as well, but they cost a little bit more money and they take a bit more time to get to. So if you're in Dunedin for a day or 2 days, these are probably the things that you're going to want to do.
First up is the Esplanade. It's actually the cafe right on the corner. There's lots of different cafes. The Esplanade itself is like a little Italian place that serves wood-fired pizzas, which are amazing. It's a nice place to go for if it's sunny or if it's raining, you can have a look out at the beach as well. Nice date option. We go to
Long Dog, yeah.
Yeah, which is right at the end, and it's got the saltwater pool attached to it as well. And the water's amazing.
Would highly recommend going to the saltwater pool. Even if you don't go in. It's like 28 degrees there.
They heat it. It's a hot one at the
top. Yeah, so even on a cold day, it's still a warm pool. It's really nice. I think its entry is about $6.70 to get in. And then you've also got the St. Clair Beach. St. Clair and St. Kilda is actually one beach. It's just different ends that they name one and the other. It's really cool to go down, a nice relaxing walk down the beach. They've got like the old remnants of this wharf that used to be there, which is really nice. And if you're a surfer, there are some awesome waves that you can go and check out.
You need a cap and some booties because it's cold.
Next up, street art. There's so much of it around Dunedin. We've actually got a little map that we've linked down below that you can actually search up, and then it'll tell you where all the main street arts are kept around Dunedin.
It also tells you a little bit about each artwork as well, who did it, I think, and nice. Just like the meanings behind them, which is really cool.
Yeah. A lot of them are around the Vogel Street area, which is boop.
And there's lots of cafes there too.
It's really cool to see though, just on the side of the streets. And they're huge. So another one of the must-see things to do in Dunedin is the First Church of Dunedin.
It's located in the heart of the city, on Moray Place, and it's about 100 metres south of the city centre. It's regarded as the most impressive of New Zealand's 19th century churches.
It's pretty cool. All jokes aside though, guys, this church is huge, it's massive, and they literally moved a hill to build the church on top of the hill. Next up, we've got the train station.
And guys, this is the most exciting fact that I love to tell everyone, that it is the second most photographed building in the Southern Hemisphere. It is beautiful. I mean, we've taken a lot of photos. We probably added a lot to that.
Similar style to the first church because they were built in the similar age. And try and go early if you can because a lot of tour buses do turn up. Some of the tourists can get quite pushy as well, so if you are going to go, try and get in early before all the tour buses and all the cruise ships get in.
You can also go in if you want to see, there's like a sports hall of fame. Next up, the Otago University, and the most beautiful building there is the clock tower. It was actually under construction for a really long time.
So now you can get those picturesque photos with the clock tower in the background. Watch out for the uni students though, because they tend to hog it on graduation day.
Yeah. Check the dates, don't go on graduation because there'll be a lot of people. But other than that, you can get amazing photos. And there's like the little Leith River, it's not really little, but the Leith River runs all the way through. There's lots of stairs, so you can take a picnic as well.
Yeah.
It's also a stone from Scotland.
Don't get lost, it's quite big.
Next up we have Baldwin Street, which is the steepest street in the world.
Woo! I think the bottom of the hill to the top of the hill is about 47 metres up. So yeah, it's a lot of ground to cover. Take me to places I have never been. I'm riding with you to the very end. Cause baby,
ooh, anywhere you go, I will worship you like it's a Sunday. Once every year they used to do a Jaffa race. It was really, really cool. They had different coloured Jaffas, and I'm pretty sure you could buy a raffle, and if your Jaffa won, you won a prize.
But how many Jaffas did they have go down? It was enough Jaffas to cover the entire road. Go for a walk, go for a hike. Don't try and run. I think the record someone was trying to beat was 2 minutes to get up the top. He got about halfway and then had to stop and sit down. So if you think you're a fit person,
do it.
Take on the challenge. We might go back later in the year and see if we can do it.
Yeah, 300 subscribers, we'll run up Baldwin.
Last but not least,
Signal Hill. You can see the whole city from there, so you can get the whole view of the harbour. And then the city and the beach as well. But it's absolutely amazing. During the day you can see everything, and at night the lights just are absolutely beautiful.
So it's a bit of a drive to get up there, so you will need a car or to be pretty reasonably fit to be able to run. But it's definitely worth the thing. If you're only in Dunedin for 1 day, we would definitely recommend doing it as the end of your trip just to finish off Dunedin. That was our top things to do in Dunedin. We hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like down below.
Subscribe to the channel and don't forget to turn on the little bell, the notifications. I know most of you probably know.
Other things that we didn't name, the pineapple track, which we kind of went over but not really. The butterfly museum.
The settlers museum.
We hope you enjoyed the video, guys. I hope this was a little bit helpful for you if you're doing some research on where you want to go and what you want to see in Dunedin. Other than that, stay safe. We'll see you in the next one.
Bye.